this video, we'll show the basics of accessing the windows and doors library, locating and sizing them within a wall, how they can be moved and copied after placement, and how parameters can be adjusted. We'll use a BIM that is developed in some of the later videos where the basics are brought together. To access the window and doors library, just have the cursor in the workspace. Right-click, select BIM Insert from the quad, and a browser appears showing the default library options. There are a wide range of options. We'll start with a simple exterior window. When inserting a window, there are three main things to consider. 1. The surface it will be inserted on. 2. Where it is located on that surface. 3. The size of the window. All three can be done within the same command. When the window is pulled on the surface, dynamic dimensions appear to assist placement. The one highlighted in blue can be edited directly, or hitting Tab allows us to move through the four options. We'll set the bottom 900mm above the floor and 2000mm from the side wall. At this point, we could hit Enter to complete the placement, or we could edit the size of the window. The black submenu at the base of the workspace indicates that by hitting Control, we can activate another mode. Now we can edit the size of the window. Hitting Enter takes us back to the location in the wall mode, and a second Enter completes the placement of the window in the wall. The process for inserting a door is the exact same. Select BIM Insert from the quad, select a door, move it onto the surface, set the dimensions for its location as needed, set the dimensions for its size as needed, hit Enter or Enter twice to complete. A quick best practice tip to insert another window or door that is already included in the BIM is to highlight it and then select BIM Insert from the quad. This automatically chooses that window type, and we are ready to locate it. Another way to include multiple versions is to just copy or array a window or door already inserted. Let's select the door, and using Copy, we'll include two more instances in this wall. Windows and doors can be edited after they have been placed as well. Let's take a closer look at the window by selecting it. The properties are now displayed on the right. At the bottom is the section that defines what parameters are associated with the window. At a basic level, we can change the width or the height. By creating a section and zooming in, we can explore the other parameters associated with the window. Such as the placement depth, rebate, frame thickness, and others. The ability to refine and adapt the design is right at your fingertips. Take some time to explore the library of window and door options, how you can locate and size them in a model, as well as how you can copy and change parameters. The possibilities are endless. Be sure to watch the next BricsCAD BIM Basics video.